Well, you see the entry of the men. It's the men's singles here in Shanghai, the GAC Group 2012 ITTF World Tour. It's the China Open, and the introduction of the officials, of course. But Ma Long and Su Xin really, really in incredible form this morning. Semi-finals, of course. Ma Long accounting for Wang Liqin, the number seven seed, in a most impressive manner. One in four straight games, 4-8, 7-7, and Wang Liqin, he played as hard as he could, and of course, three-time world champion, you'd expect him to still have a few very, very impressive shots. But Ma Long, his determination and his focus this week has been stunning. Very, very impressive. So we'll see whether or not Ma Long can take this title. He teamed up with Wang Hao, of course, and won the doubles already. So this could be a double tournament title for him. He has been the Mr. Pro Tour, Mr. World Tour, in terms of the number of times he's been successful. In fact, that extraordinary number of matches that he'd won, a number of games that he'd won on the run, just broken by Zhang Zhike earlier in the year. But he's back now to his very best, although he was a little blip last week. Li Sungzhou beat him in the round of 16, but he is the quintessential Chinese table tennis player. He's clean cut, he's very, very athletic, and he is everything you'd expect from a champion. He's not actually won the world title. That honor belongs to Zhang Zhike. But and he's not got an Olympic title, but maybe London will be his time. Ma Long, very, very impressive Ma Long. Su Xin, on the other hand, he's 22 years old. Left-handed penhold grip, there he is. Really impressive with the way he came back against Zhang Zhike, who'd beaten him for the final, the title in Korea last week. But, after threatening, Zhang Zhike was really, really blown away by Su Xin. 4-2 was the final score, and it was amazing to see. So we will, in just a couple of moments, be underway. In terms of their performance prior to this, Ma Long, mentioned he'd beaten Wang Liqin 4-0, but he'd also beaten Chuang, and that was a good performance, 4-1. And, well, you have to say that the Chinese Taipei guy, having beaten Francisca earlier, was quite a threat. He'd beaten a couple of Europeans, actually, Vlasov as well. But Ma Long took out Chuang. He also accounted for Kokiniwa. That was a much closer encounter, 4-2, the young Japanese star, another Japanese player, Takikawa, was a little bit easier at 4-0, and 4-0 for Matthias Carlsen as well, he beat in the first round. So Ma Long gets to this stage, having given up three games, but is still very, very strong in that the bottom of the draw. Zhang Zhike was number two, and in fact came unstuck against Su Xin, and that was a 4-2 scoreline. Su Xin also accounted for Oh Sang-yun, who beat Ma Lin brilliantly in a 4-2 victory, but Su Xin won 4-0. It was easy. 5-5, 6-8. And then Su Xin, going further back, beat Chan from Japan, Dong Yun from Korea, and also another Korean, Lee Sung Yun. So it's still love all. Su Xin in service. Ma Long, he looks really lively, I have to say. This is going to be a very, very interesting matchup. We've still got Jens with us, and he'll give us some summaries in between some of the points and between the games. Jens.
Yeah, it's wonderful to watch. I think these two players now, they are really, really in a good form. And they're really, really psyched also to become the champion here in China. So this is going to be a thrilling and very, very quality match.
They're moving on their seats. They're that excited. Good to see. They won't be watching this with anything else but a favorite out there, I can tell you. They know their table tennis, the Chinese public. Oh. He really wound that one up, did Ma Long. That was meant. Technically, they're both brilliant. They've got such extraordinary skills. They can improvise. They can strategize. Very impressive. How dare he get that ball back? Goodness me, Zhu Xin. It looked like he was a lamb to the slaughter there, but by golly, he really was very determined to keep this ball in motion. Look at that. And again, oh no, not the third time. Aha! You beauty, that's what undid Jaquir a couple of times.
There is a small, small spot out in the far, far out in the forehand side, which also is always is interesting to play, because that's really difficult for the opponent to reach.
3-5. Who's going to blink first? This is a poker game with a ball. Ha ha! Well, Zhu Xin found the net and it went long, but I tell you, great patience there shown by Ma Long. He was just content to keep it in play. He didn't try to counter-attack, which he's capable of course. 3-6. And that, of course, puts a little bit of pressure on the scoreboard, which puts a little bit of pressure on the opponent. Clever play by Ma Long. He is in dynamic form, is Ma Long. Not for nothing is he the number one in the world. And I tell you, this really elusive big title that he's going to be chasing, it's got to happen soon. But Zhu Xin conceded the first game in the semi-final and still came through so very strongly. He finds a way. He's an intimidating player, Zhu Xin. When you think you've got him locked into a corner, he can always battle out of it. 4-8. He's also got this little complex about not being in the first team for London. Something to prove. But he's going to be struggling here in this first game. Ma Long's got a 10-4 advantage in the first, and it's just been quality play. It's been exciting. It has been dynamic. I've used the word several times, but it's also been in control. I missed that one. again, a little bit of patience displayed by Su Xing. Didn't get carried away too early, and that paid off. Still got a big, big battle here, though, in the first. He's got the serve, but he's 4 points adrift. That's good. That's it. It's 11-6 in the first. Ma Long thoroughly deserving this opening victory in the game. It's the final of the men's singles here in Shanghai. The GAC Group 2012 ITTF World Tour. And I tell you, it's coming to a very suitable climax. Okay, it's China v China, but the talent that we see here on display is so exciting. I hope you're enjoying it wherever you are in the world. 11-6 in the first. Ma Long, he deserves it, Jens.
So now is the question here if Susin can find some solutions to put some sand in the machinery of Malone.
Some good analysis there from Jens Völker, who has several books on the subject of table tennis, and it's been his life, actually. That's a fantastic shot there from Susin. 2-0, got a bit lucky with the first at the net, but the second one was totally, totally his own making. Great shot. And again, that's the kind of shot that brought him through to this final stage against Jicker. And three. Never discount this powerfully built man. Both of these guys could play any sport that they ever fancied. There's no question about that. They've got the perfect bodies. In fact, I'd like him in my rugby team, please, Susin. He can come in the back row and chase anything down and tackle. Well, he'd set it up well enough. It was good thinking by Ma Long. That's why he's shaking his head there, because he knew he had the chance. It was a lovely, lovely set-up ball, and then the forehand just didn't work for him.
No, I think that Susin has a new way of playing now. He felt in the first set, Ma Long tried to nail him, Susin, in the backhand corner, and was quite successful with that. Now Susin changes. Now he plays much more to the forehand to Ma Long, and then he made a variation here. The backhand, which then came very, very surprisingly from Malone. So, but three of the points so far in the game, he got out in the forehand corner with his own attack. So, can he keep the receive short and then go for the attack? Maybe far out in the forehand, sometimes in the backhand, then he could be in charge.
It's not working for Malone this game. So, Sin is in great shape at 1-7 in the second. Distraction. That's not coming back. Even the ball was screaming help. He had time for a twiddle of the bat there. Do you see it?
Yeah. They like to play with the other side because it's more, they have more dynamic in that sort of shot with the other side.
Just little nuances you only pick up in replay, I tell you, because I didn't notice it in live play. Ma Long bravely fighting here, but Su Xin has still got the 4-point advantage and the serve. Now he's missed that. Was that an ambitious backhand, or was it a really good serve from Su Xin? Hard to tell. How can you do that? That's not allowed. Superhuman, that one from Tucson. Crikey. All the pen holders of the world unite. My goodness. Wow. You just can't believe what has happened. This is now a complete turnaround in fortune. 3-10. It's 7 game points. Oh, did it take the edge? It did. Crikey. Well, a little bit of luck there for Ma Long. You have to say that he paid for it, but millimeters from losing this first game. He's still got to make up 5 points, and it's odds on that Zhu Xin will level. Which he duly does right now. It's 11-5 in the second, so one all in games. And Zhu Xin has suddenly found his range. He's got that kind of play that we saw against Jaquet in the semi-final. And he is putting pressure on Ma Long. It is a fascinating battle.
The key here for Zhu Xin is the serving receipts. And he knows how to do well here. He's very, 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 very good feeling in his wrist. You know, he has a great feeling in the wrist. So he really puts the ball over.
Well, he had problems last week. He's rectified them this week. He's already a champion in the doubles. He was on his way. He's now been just stopped in his tracks a little bit. Zhu Xin, again, dynamic player, and it's very, very impressive to watch. He's so quick. He's got such a reach. Middle of the table, no problem to keep the pressure on. Interesting, that grip. When we see it, when it sets up, the edge of the two fingers that are holding the pen holder, it doesn't appear to get round the handle at all. It's just on the blade. Very interesting. He would have expected to get that one back. He saw it early enough. He moved into good position. Ma Long now knows what he's got in terms of the challenge. It's a chess game, isn't it? Brilliant. Oh, you devil! You dare not do that! How many times? Crikey! Oh, man. Lots of heavy side spin on that, but look at this. Ma Long again thought he'd won the point, and then it comes back with interest. Well, he adjusted his position. I think that was from the side. I think that the umpire will give that to Ma Long, surely. Let's have a look at this. Does it take the... Come on, tell me.
Yeah, I think
you think it is a point?
Yeah, I think it's from the
okay.
Side. Yeah.
All right.
Well, not easy to see. They seem that you agree also, the players.
From that side, that would have been a tough call for the umpire. Not so that one. 3-3.
Yeah, you see it all the time when Sin makes something. He must do it with a great deal of power because he placed the ball at the same place with a little less power than Malin immediately is there and he can counter attack.
That's
it's really, really a matter of, you know, small differences in the power and the pace.
That's why we're seeing so much spectacular play from Susim, and he's successful. Yeah, it's very interesting.
And this was also the difference when he turned the match against Zhang Jike in the semi-final. That was exactly what happened, that he could play it the same game but harder.
Mm-hmm.
And in the beginning he was a little bit too soft, and mm-hmm. there was no chance.
Yep.
So he's really on the edge there, you know, the edge of the knife. Where
it's 4-4. It's 1-1. It's very exciting.
That's very clever also from Susim. He takes it slow, you know, with a lot of spin in the ball, but he takes it slow, a little higher, slow. Then Malong has to adjust his forehand, and then he plays a little bit too long.
We love it. We absolutely love it. Ma Long is victorious there. But really, the way in which that ball comes back at speed and with interest, it's just extraordinary. Susim loves to mix those up as well. He is quite spectacular. I think Ma Long is a little bit more economic with his movements. Susim really gets into it. It's quite spectacular. Good work from Ma Long there. And there's lonely Wang Lijin, three-time world champion. Norman Nomates up in the stadium, way away from the crowd, but very interested in what's happening on court. It only needs a couple of errors for his head to go down a little bit. That's the only worrying thing. He's just got to maintain that concentration.
Yes, I think it's the first time actually in the semi-final and the final here where he really, you know, you can see that he is disappointed. Before he was quite stone-faced and seemed to be very, you know, has his direction clear, but maybe here something happens in his head.
That's clever. High ball toss is doing its job at the moment. Ma Long trying to play the receiving short, but he's a very, very long reaching live player. He can get there very early. And it's doing its job again. He levels up at sevens. What's the advantage of the high ball toss, do you think?
Well, it's a little bit distraction for the opponent, because it takes a long time until what really happens when they meet when the ball meet the paddle. So, and it's also, of course, you get some extra speed in the ball compared with the low. So that means that.
There's not a lot you can actually say about that, except wow. I think the word wow was actually created for that moment.
Well, just with the high toss, serve is also that when you get this higher pace on the ball when it comes down, it also makes possibility and opportunities for you to make more spin in this.
Isn't this interesting? Just look at the way Susim has taken 4 points in a row. He was a bit disappointed with his performance and then suddenly took a towel down, thought about it, and look at what's happened. A couple of great services, one big rally, and now 9-7. Oh, he's in absolutely extraordinary, undeniably creative, very, very up for this. He's determined to upset the apple cart for the team in the Olympic Games. How about this? Sensational stuff. Had to run 5 meters to get even close to it. It is just brilliant table tennis. Almost got it back, you know. Marlon, forever pendulum-like in terms of his consistency. But he's being tested here. I suppose metronomic would probably be a better word, but he's really fighting hard here because this is a big game. The third game of any match like this is important. It's the final of a major World Tour event just before the Olympic Games. There's everything at stake here. Reputation, as well as the big honor of a major World Tour event title. He's got it leveled at 10-all. That is quite remarkable. Ma Long fights back here. And who's to say he won't take this game now? Great chances for Su Xin. He couldn't make it. But to his great credit, he kept his plan in place and tried to attack. 10-all. 1-all in games. Ma Long, the court was open there. Yeah, and you know he's talking to himself because he normally does not miss those. With that little shake of the head, it's all forgotten. It's all new, it's all ahead, it's all future. It's 10-11, but still a game point against him. That is fantastic finish. Su Xin picks up the third. It's 2-1 in games. The final here in Shanghai is proving to be an absolute cracker. Well, there's not a great deal more you can say about Su Xin, is there? He's just so, so impressive with his exuberance as much as anything else. What's at stake really is to put a statement out that he, although he's not in the main team, if he can get into the reserve position, Su Xin certainly, I mean, he would be the number one in any other team in the world without any question or doubt at all. This is high quality. This is China. This is table tennis. And we love what we're seeing. 1-2 in games. Problem in China, you reach the top and there's so many bricks being thrown at you to try and get you off that perch. There's no time to rest. And they learn that from a very early age. You don't make it, I'm sorry, bye-bye, it's ruthless. Made a couple of errors, in fact, a big error there at 10-all in the previous game off that forehand side from the middle, and he really, really missed another one there.
Ball and he makes this check flick, and this check flick is very difficult for the server, because he can hide the placement of the ball for a very long time. He doesn't know if it comes in the backhand corner or in the forehand corner. So that means that he's a little bit hesitating on the next point. But I think that Susan will move his serve out to the forehand more for Marong, so he doesn't get this possibility to really hide the placement.
Oh.
How much energy. Oh dear. Spectacular stuff. The crowd love it. It's the oohs and the ahs time when they get into that. But there were some extraordinary shots. And the one I remember, rather than the deep ones there and the attacking shots, was that backhand from Marlon that set it all up. It was absolutely superb. Just like you said, I think it was the check flick that you described. And it went sideways after it reached the opposition tight pole.
Susan seeks the forehand instead, so Marlong should not have the opportunity to make this check trip so much.
The change of service was unbelievable, and immediately he kept the attack momentum by just keeping on with the power. That was after that was the third shot. This is the fifth, down the line, and it's the winner.
Surprise there, a really surprise long serve to the backhand and paid off.
Being treated here to some excellent play, and Su Xin is actually taking just a little bit more than 50% of it, I have to say. He's really impressing. Well, I tell you, that was an all or nothing from Marlong, because if Su Xin had got anything at all on the backhand, he was dead. He just gambled to stay out wide on that backhand side, and just, well, it was all or nothing. It worked. Good on him. 5-all. Suddenly, we do get a backhand from Marlong. Into the corner. It's tight, it's close, it's really exciting here. Shanghai supporters loving this. Difficult to know what he's thinking, because he doesn't wear his heart on his sleeve either. Marlong is very, very subdued in terms of his visual perspective. He doesn't shout and scream a lot. He just gets get on with it. But he knows he's being really challenged here. He's down by one game. No wonder Su Xin is turning away in disappointment. He had that one covered. And you have to ask yourselves, the Chinese are at this level because why? Very simply, they are playing at this level in practice. That's the extraordinary thing. When do you get the chance to play against somebody of similar ilk? It's such, well, self-prophesying, really. It's a good touch there from Marlong. And he's now got this very important 3-point lead in the fourth. It's going to go to 12-10 in the seventh, you know that. Su Xin doesn't do it any other way. He lost out last week to Jigger in the seventh in Korea. And I love the way the crowd are into this. Every point. Ma Long would like that ball back again, please. Can I serve again? Su Xin was absolutely on it so fast, and this is now real danger for Ma Long. He's got the lead, but Su Xin, aha, now that is interesting. Taking a timeout, Ma Long. Is this a, well, it's a Liu Guoliang kind of move, isn't it?
But I think the thing here is that he had him, you saw the expression from Su Xin, right? When he was, he had a spontaneous reaction that was kind of not really the same thing like the stone face thing that he has been showing. That shows the eagerness for him to really win these points, because, you know, 6-6, then it's a couple of points, then he has 3-1, then he has it, right? So this is really a crucial moment of the match. And also Ma Long feels it, he must win this, because 1-3 will be very difficult for him to catch up.
That's the situation. We're in timeout at the moment, 9-8. Ma Long is really struggling at the moment to take any kind of dominant position over Su Xin. Su Xin is just being outrageous with his ambition, and I tell you, it's been very successful and very exciting. We're in the entertainment game, let's face it, and he is doing his job brilliantly. I hope you're enjoying it wherever you are in the world, because this is sensational table tennis. He's taken it to 10, and you have to say that was a very, very good timeout. Great work from Ma Long. Take the pressure off him a little bit here. See this one home, and at 2-2, it's a totally different ball game. Clever play from Su Xin to keep it down the middle. Didn't give him any opportunities to get width, and then cramped him up a little bit, trying to get that big forehand moving. The champion, we don't know whose name will be on it. It's interesting, Ma Long doesn't talk to himself very much or very often. It's still game point. That's great backhand to seal the fourth game, 11-9, and Ma Long fights. And I tell you what, that was very, very good. A tigerish performance in the fourth by Ma Long. It really took all his reserves of strength and really improvisation, because Su Xin is putting so much pressure on here. Really, really tough. 2-2 in the men's singles final here in the GAC Group 2012 ITTF World Tour. The China Open is coming to a great, great conclusion. Brief interlude. They're not exactly cheerleaders, dancers maybe, but the pom-poms are there, and certainly the ambition of these two wonderful, wonderful players is for all to see. Here we go, Su Xin, fifth game, he starts it. Oh, just took it at the perfect height to play it around the corner. There's a lot of movement on this one. Watch this now. He reaches And that is just the perfect height to play it down the line. Scoreline absolutely reflective of the play. Missed it there on that. Marlon doesn't normally move. So uneasily there. He normally makes those. Oh, what a change of direction. That's what's so stunning, isn't it, about this whole match.
Yeah, and he, what he does is that he prepared this with a very great receive, very very short to the forehand for Malong. Then he got the opportunity to be aggressive, and then he takes the final shot in the other corner.
Even then, Su Sim was not looking at blocking anything. He was coming back with interest. And that attempted forehand is just, his ambitions are just so, so spectacular. Su Sim, 3-2, now 4-2, 2-4. He's done it once. He's recovered, but he's going to have to do it more and more. And actually, this is a great, great warm-up match for the Olympics, isn't it? I mean, this is just the perfect kind of atmosphere and perfect kind of test. Come on. Come on, you boys. Ha, ha. Whoa. Pistols at dawn, knives out, I tell you. Street fighters or what? It's spectacular stuff. 3-4. Who wants to play table tennis? Put your hands up. How many hundred million do we see raise their hands right there? Because that is special. This is why these guys are so excited. This is why they love it. This is why seeing this excellence of talent, an expression of appreciation of a magnificent game, they just, well, couldn't be better. In a funny way, they're loving it, they're enjoying it. It's not actually pressure, it's what they do. So Sin comes back, he lost two of the big battles from deep, he's just picked up one. But it's not the battles, it's the war. We want to see who's the winner. Too much pressure there from Su Sim on the forehand side again. He's back to a two-point lead. Again. The big battles from deep. Ma Long has generally won them because of consistency. So Sin's ambition sometimes just a little bit too difficult. Within one again, 5-6.
That's a serve that is, really showing now that Malong feels the pressure, because this is a half long serve and it's easy for Su Sim to make Malong passive in the backhand, corner there. So I don't think it was his intention.
A little doubt, that's what you're saying, mm-hmm. in Ma Long's mind, which is not a great thing. Tries that. I'm going to get used to using the term the Czech flick.
The service was too short, so it was not easy to get it up. Also placed where it is difficult for him to reach it.
Susin in serve at 8-5. Such a finite thing, this game. Just millimeters, milliseconds. And the disappointment comes into play. 6-8. That is absolutely right into Su Sin's hands there. Ma Long a little bit nervous, plays it down through the middle. You don't do that to Su Sin. Watch out. This is bombs away. Fantastic forehand, middle to out. And he's got a handy lead here now. 3-point lead, 6-9. They come disguised from under the table, both sides now. It is quite spectacular. I mean, it is unbelievable standard. Well, you can read the scoreboard as well as I can. And he deserves that position at the moment. It's two all in games, but Su Sin has got 3 game points. He's got the service as well, so he'll dictate the start.
Oh. It's his serving and receiving game is just incredible here at Su Sin. I think he does it perfect, really perfect, and as soon as the ball comes up a little bit, then he's there, not even just put the flick on, but really with a hard flick, like a small smash coming there from the net, and it's impossible for Ma Long to even react on this one.
Ma Long was looking to try and get the first attack in. He didn't have a chance to do that. And there's the result of it. It's 11-7. So Su Sin again has got into a position where he can take a title. Exactly the same. He had match point against Jang Dekir last week in a similar event in Incheon, Korea, in the World Tour. I'm not sure that he's in the mood to relax and give this one up. He's got a very precious fifth game. We go to the sixth now, and Ma Long has got to do something a little bit special. We've always given him credit for being able to think a little bit. Let's just see whether he can think his way through this one now, because Su Sin will punish him if he's anything less than accurate and if he puts it into his really good positive areas. There you go. Where do you put it? You look for the backhand side. He runs round the backhand and comes onto his strength. This is a problem for Ma Long now.
Yes, I think that he feels some sort of a little bit disoriented here, how to make it, because he must really put hard spin or pace on the ball deep down to the corner of the backhand corner or the forehand corner to get Su Sin in a more passive mood. But still, also these small points he now starts to miss. This is very unrare. Normally he hardly never misses this one. So he's really disturbed now. It's obvious.
Su Sin picks up on the backhand there. 2-0. Got to be something special. It's got to be early in the play as well. And the camera Our host CCTV have done a great job this week, bringing us great pictures, some fantastic entertainment. Disappointed with himself there. He just is such a perfectionist. But maybe Marlon can pick up on it. It's just those small, small little things that Marlon can take advantage of. Both touched the top of the net there, but Marlon's was out of play as a result. He's not looking dejected, but he's certainly not looking comfy. Oh, sensational. Did we say the strength was his forehand? Bah!
Here you can see that Malong, he tries to make a side spin, overspin service to get the ball long, and he gets it long, but he's not confident enough to really go on that one. And then he hesitates a little bit, he gives Susin a little time, and then it's just boom.
Magnificent, Susin.
Ooh.
Again, he comes up with an absolute cracker from inside, in fact, down the center. Marlon's going to have to do something very, very radical here. He's going to have to attack on the flanks, maybe just try to stretch him and get an early attack. But Susin is just being absolutely dominant at the moment. And that looks like the face of a guy that knows it. Marlon is under pressure. He's not missing anything either. Susin, look at this, at 2-6 now. 5 points away of taking a huge scalp here in Shanghai. And I still say that being missed out of the Olympic team has motivated him hugely. It's all happening in favor of Susin.
I mean, here's play. He plays too, right? He plays here with the spin, and he make a playful shot, and even falls out that he get these points.
Again, he's got the money in the bank. He's already invested. He's done his saving. Now he can spend. And when he's got a four-point lead like this, I can tell you now, he was dynamic when he was behind. What's he going to be like when he's leading like this? It just gives him a wonderful platform from which to attack. Ooh. Been special, but listen, there's a lot of Marlon supporters here, and that is a call by Susin, is it? Or was that a Marlon? It has to be a Susin.
Yes, this I guess is a Li Guoliang call, because he's in the lead, he has it, but he feels also that he got to get his concentration together now for the last crucial points, because now he also has this last serving. And then there are two serves from Malong, and then he really needs this point to get 8-4, so he has some sort of margin for the rest of the game.
He held match point against Zhang Jike last week in Korea, and it looks very much as if Susin, keeping this kind of momentum, can take the title here in Shanghai. It would be a huge fillip for him. It would give the administrators of China something to think about as well, in terms of who they're taking to London. But the decision about the full team has already been made, and he's not in it. And that is a really good interpretation of the timeout there by Jens. And I have to say, 8-4 now looks very, very good for Susin. He's not in it. Ma Long's heart is not in this now. He went through the motions, but there was no feeling for that service. And I tell you, Tzu Tsin is absolutely in control of this. His brain is now absolutely buzzing with excitement. And that is the result. Ma Long has been beaten by the power play, but also a huge amount of clever tactic and strategy from Tzu Tsin. It's match point. Uh-oh, here we go. A little playful thing from Ma Long. The last point. And the crowd, do they like it? I think they must. How close to the net can you go? Oh my goodness me, it's in the crowd and Ma Long has given it away. The handshakes come in and he has admitted defeat. The number one in the world brings a smile from the number four in the world. Tzu Tsin, I tell you, that was absolutely stunning. A little bit of fun at the end there, but Tzu Tsin could easily have had back-to-back victories. Ma Long satisfied with the doubles because he knows he's been whipped here by a very impressive Tzu Tsin. In every respect, he was on top of his game. He has impressed us not only with the fact that he's won, but it's the style of his winning and the fact that he really dominated so many aspects of that game. It was a superb effort by Tzu Tsin. And I can tell you now, maybe Ma Long will have to wait a bit longer if he wants to get that big title, because Tzu Tsin will be chasing big time. Let's hear from Jens again about his verdict on this final here in Shanghai.
Well, I think it's really incredible. I think Tzu Tsin has made it unbelievably well. And the thing is, the question that he sends now to the management of the Chinese Association is, are you really sending the best players to London? Because at this time, and how he make it, it's like 4-2 against Zhang Jike in the semifinals, it's 4-2 here, and he really, really play them out. I mean, it's not really even. You can say that he really dominates it, and he really, really are better, the better player. So I think that something has happened during these 2 weeks, really, something very important. And this is Tzu Tsin. He was a very promising player. He was the number one under 21 in the world. But now he's really challenging the real top three guys. And he is maybe the same level.
Look at the adoring fans. They know their table tennis. And I can tell you, the number of top quality rallies we saw during that match, Ma Long put everything into that. He did not give that match away. Tzu Tsin actually won it through strategy, through power, through pace and through sheer talent. It was absolutely amazing. Look at the footwork, look at the energy he's putting into it, and look, more importantly about everything else, look at the motivation. It was stunning. Love the match, love the result, and I tell you what, although we've got China v China, I can tell you now, when we see those kind of examples of brilliant table tennis on display, we don't care whether it's China v China, because at the end of the day, we see something very special. Tzu Tsin is definitely challenging for the top.